Hello, Chris again. I've got another Hey Chris question. This time I've got, Hey Chris, my band is about to go into the studio for the first time. Any advice? Yes, I do. I remember the first time my first band went into the studio. It was a complete and utter disaster. Basically, I did everything wrong. So if you want some advice, you came to the right person. Number one, know the songs. You have to know the songs inside out, backwards. You have to be able to play this pretty much in your sleep. You should know it that well. You just know your parts inside out, backwards, because in the studio it's completely different than live. It's just, I can't really explain it in words. It's just a totally different environment, different mindset that you need. So just knowing the songs inside out, backwards. Being able to play your parts to a click track, to a metronome, because that's what's going to happen in the studio, especially if you're with a drummer. What happened with me is the drummer had his parts down fine, that wasn't a problem. And then he left the room, because his parts were already done. And then I was left with either a click track or listening to his drums. I was so used to jamming with him and having the visual clues of where the timing was, that without that, I was completely and utterly lost. So being able to play your parts to a metronome, very, very important. Next bit of advice, sort out your gear. Very important. Guitar players, you have to change your strings the night before going into the studio. Have spare sets on hand. It always helps with the tone, having nice clean strings. Sort out your amps. Having your amp serviced just before going to the studio is a really good idea. Don't drop it off to the service place a couple of days before your session. You probably won't get your amp back. So do it a couple of weeks before and you should be right. Also get your guitar serviced so you know it's 100% ready to go. You don't want just like a wire to sort of fail on you in the studio. Something that could be a quick fix, but not in the studio. Could be averted if you'd gotten that serviced and looked at sooner rather than later. So definitely get it serviced. Last piece of advice, go in with an open mind. So have a totally open mind. If the sound engineer recommends something, go with it. Just trust that they know what they're doing. At the end of the day, they want to get like a good recording too, because it looks good on their resume as well. So they are on your side, they are trying to make you sound really good. So go on with an open mind, you can't go wrong. Hopefully that gave you some tips. Thank you for your questions again. If you do have any questions, just send them through to chris@musiccavern.com.au. Cheers, catch you next time.